Today I'm going to show you the guts of the HTC M9. This is a very difficult phone to work on, so attempt it at your own risk. I'm going to go ahead and turn the phone off, unplug it, remove my braided cable. To get inside of the phone, you have to remove this black plastic piece up at the top. Just kind of slide a little tool underneath and lift up one of the clasps. Then there's some adhesive and then another clasp along the other side. Pop that out and put it somewhere safe. It's really important to stay totally organized during this repair. Make sure to keep all your screws in one spot where you'll remember where they go. I will link tools and parts in the video description below, so check that out. Remove the SD card slot and the SIM card slot on the other side of the phone with your SIM card removal tool. And then you can take a plastic pry tool up at the top of the phone and lift it out just a little bit. This was extremely difficult to separate the screen from the back metal housing of the phone. I ended up taking my pry tool, leaving it in the top, and then sliding a metal tool between the frame and the back plate. And that's kind of releasing the clasps that hold the front of the phone into the back of the phone and stuck in there pretty tight. So you have to be a little bit aggressive with it. Once one side was open, the other side came out a lot easier. I was able to use my plastic tool for that. And then the back separated from the front of the phone. Pretty straightforward. No adhesive or anything else inside of there. Here is the back metal plate. You can see little grooves along this back side. What's interesting is this is a brand new phone, and there is a screw up in the right-hand corner that's just completely missing. So I'm not sure if that missed HTC's quality control or what. Anyway, unplug the battery. I always do that first, just so there's no electricity coursing through the phone while I'm working on it. Don't want to fry anything. Lift off those two little wire cables, and then each one of the ribbon cables has a piece of tape on it. So lift that off, lift up the clasp, and then you'll be able to slide that ribbon cable out of the connector. Lucky for you, there's like 500 other ribbon cable connectors in this phone, so you get lots of practice. Lift up each of the little latches and slide out each of the little ribbon cables. It's all kinds of fun. This whole video is pretty much watching me disconnect things. There's so many different connections inside of this phone. Some more wire connectors, some more ribbon connectors, some metal tape along some more ribbon cable connectors. Make sure to keep this tape in a special spot because you're going to be putting it back on the phone when you're done. It's kind of a little shield. Lift up another little clasp. This is the ribbon cable connector for the LCD screen. There's three screws holding on the motherboard. I'm gonna move this black cable and then another ribbon cable connector down at the bottom. This one's for the bottom speaker. It's a cute little guy. Just pull that out of its little hole. And then the vibrator motor. It's interesting that every single thing has a connector on here except for the vibrator motor. Four screws at the bottom. Vibrator motor is just soldered onto the main board, which is silly. Now the motherboard comes out and it is connected to the bottom speaker just by some adhesive, so I just pop that out. Bottom speaker is here. I'll try to link replacement parts in the video description below. Here's the wonderful vibrator motor that's soldered onto the main board for some reason. And here's the charging port. Charging ports are one of the first things that go out in phones, so I'll link that down in the description below when that becomes available. Has a little metal bracket on top, I'm guessing to provide support. There's four screws along the top part of the motherboard. Here's another connection here. HTC like connections so much they put connections on their connections. Now that that's off, we can go ahead and lift up this other ribbon cable connector on this other side above the SIM card tray. And then there's a little clasp that holds the camera in, so make sure to undo that clasp before you try to lift out the daughterboard. The daughterboard does have two little latches up on the top that you have to disconnect as well before it lifts out from the phone. Beware of the front-facing camera as well. It tries to stay down in that little hole. Cameras disconnect. They're like little Lego pieces from the main board. Just unsnap those connections. Here's a 20-megapixel camera. The front-facing camera has some metallic tape, copper tape. It's kind of like a shield or a grounding tape. So lift that off. Try not to take off the cameras if at all possible. They seem to be a little bit finicky when reinstalling them. Also, here's the water damage indicator sticker. Looks like it was added as an afterthought to the phone. The overall design of the phone isn't geared towards self-repair, if you haven't noticed yet. Here I am reinstalling my cameras again, and trying to stick down that metal tape as well as possible. Whether it's a grounding strap or not, it is necessary for the camera's functionality. Here is the SIM card tray. It also is attached to the power and volume buttons, so pull that off gently if you're planning on reusing it. Then here is the SD card tray. It's got the connectors on connectors here. Then the earpiece pops out of its little slot. Earpieces are always magnetized, so here's a little tip. If you take your screwdriver and rub it on top of the earpiece, it magnetizes it so you don't lose your screws. So the battery is pretty fun. There is a adhesive strip on either side of the battery. I didn't heat mine up at all, but you know, that's always an option. I just found it was easier to take a playing card or a thin piece of cardstock and slide it between and just cut through the adhesive. Put my pry tool in there to help leverage it up a little bit. Once one side was cut out, I could use my pry tool and just kind of lift off the other side. Pretty straightforward. Battery's not too difficult to remove. Just don't pry too hard against the screen if you're planning on keeping the screen. Any amount of leverage might break that. The battery itself is a 2840 milliamp hour. I will link those in the video description as well when they become available. Take off whatever black piece that was. If you're planning on keeping the screen, you want to be incredibly careful with it. Right now I'm heating up the phone to soften the adhesive that's holding the LCD and digitizer onto the midframe. Once the phone gets too hot to touch, I know the glue is ready to be separated. There's a little slot right here in the midframe that you can press up, and it'll lift the backlight and LCD away from the midframe far enough that you can take a playing card or a thin piece of cardstock and slide it between. Make sure that you get between the backlight and the midframe on that far back layer, because there's many layers to a screen, like the glass, digitizer, LCD, and backlight, and you want to be between the backlight and the midframe. If you try to separate any of the other layers, you're probably going to break your screen. Now, if your screen's already broken, obviously you don't need to be as careful as I am, but I'm going to try to put this phone back together in working order when I'm finished with it. So I'm not prying up on the screen at all, I'm just slicing through that adhesive once I've made sure I'm between the backlight and the midframe on that farthest layer. And every now and then I'll stop and reheat up the phone to make sure that the adhesive is soft enough for my card and I'm not applying too much pressure to the LCD and digitizer. It is extremely fragile and it can break very, very easily, so be very, very careful when you're removing the screen. Also be careful of the ribbon cables on that other side. I'm making sure not to pry on that side just so I don't damage the ribbon cables. Then they'll slide out of the little hole in the midframe and you should be good to go. That's how you remove the screen from the midframe on the HTC M9. I will link replacement parts in the video description, so check that out. Your new screen might come with adhesive. If not, you're going to need to take some double-sided tape and put it in place of the black adhesive that was there before. I'm going to go ahead and slide the ribbon cable through the midframe again as I'm installing my new screen back onto the phone, and then set it right down inside of the midframe. Not too difficult for a screen repair, considering how many connections there are in this phone. Putting whatever black piece that is back on the ribbon cable connectors again. Setting the SIM card slot back in place with the power button and volume buttons on that side. SD cards going back in place as well. Earpiece pressed back into its hole. Daughter board also getting pressed down in. Want to make sure that camera slips down inside of the little slot and gets latched down. Here's the two little pins on top of the motherboard. Make sure those are pinched down. The camera gets pushed down in place as well with that little clasp. And now we have a bunch of ribbon cables to put back together. This one above the SIM card tray, there's four screws on the top that you want to get screwed in. Slide the battery back into place. You can put a strip of adhesive down underneath if you want, but I think the frame of the phone is pretty secure anyway. Get the three screws that hold the charging port back into place. Set the speaker back down there in the bottom corner. Now we have a connector within a connector. Make sure that's pressed down onto the daughter board first. And make sure nothing is underneath the motherboard when you're putting it down on top of the battery. There's lots of little connections and ribbons, so make sure you pull those all up. Get that vibrator motor pressed down into place, and then we got three screws on the motherboard. Get this black wire cable pressed down as well. You want to be careful with these little connections so you don't bend them. Make sure you don't use any metal tools on these ribbon cable connectors either, because if you cut down through the plastic onto the metal, it'll short out some of the connections. So be careful with that. Get that tape that you put off to the side and put it back down on top of the connectors, its a little shield. And make sure you get all the little yellow tapes back into place over the little connections as well. That'll just help the ribbon cables stay in place if you ever drop your phone, or just over the life of the device. Your phone will last a lot longer if everything's taped back up again. Latch it down into place. Get some more of these wire cables hooked up. Press them down. There's some more wire cables down here next to the battery. Notice I haven't plugged in the battery yet because I want it to be the last thing that I plug in after all the connections have been made again and taped back into place. Now that everything's taped down and connected, I'm going to go ahead and put the battery in and then get those last two silver screws screwed into the battery connector. You can test the phone while the back is still off, just make sure not to touch any of the circuit boards that are inside. And then you just clasp the front of the phone back into the back of the phone. It's kind of like a little clamshell. Just snap it back into place. It does require a bit of force, but as long as your ribbon cable connectors lined up where they should be, you should be all right. Press it down hard and you should be good. Get those top two screws back into place, and then you have your little plastic bit. Put one corner in first, and then the other side, and you can just kind of press it back down into place. The phone went back pretty smoothly. It would be hard to tell that it was open before. Just make sure you avoid around the edges of the SIM card slots, because that's pretty fragile. Plug it back in, the charging port works fine. If you have any questions, make sure to leave them in the comments below. Don't forget to like if this video helped you, and don't forget to subscribe. Thanks a ton for watching. Hope to see you around.